What's going on, guys? It's me, Ali, and welcome back to another video of Exploring New and Tasty Out of Bound. This is now the last episode where we're gonna explore New and Tasty, because we are now reaching the end of the game. I am now gonna show you Rapture Farm Zulak 2, 3, and 4. Since they're all really short and I can just show them all in one video. Now before we do that, let's take a quick look at Free Fire Zone. It is basically the exact same as Stockyard, but there are few things that is interesting to show. So let's begin with that. Now when you start Free Fire Zone, you'll see that electric fence on the left and you wouldn't be able to get through it. But what is on the other side? Well, what happens if you go down? Nothing. Doesn't seem like anything is really happening. Another electric fence we can't get through is the one right before we have to enter the door to the Rapture Farms. Now when I move the camera to the right, it wouldn't allow me. It's completely locked. But there is a way where I can actually see how it continues. I move the camera a bit to the down and up, and I can actually continue walking through the level. It's all empty. There's absolutely nothing. No enemies, no items, no bombs. It's just the whole level of Stockyards. Completely empty. Well, that was Free Fire Zone. Let's move on to Rapture Farms itself. Now for this, I'm gonna skip Zulak 1 since we already explored at the beginning and there's definitely nothing new here. Everything is exactly the same. So we're already gonna jump into Zulak 2. Now this part here, there wasn't really anything interesting to see. But when I move the camera up, I noticed that the lighting slowly faded to black. This kind of effect wasn't really used previously in Zulak 1. It was kind of something new I saw here. Okay, not a big deal, but it's a thing. Okay, enough of that. Let's explore this door here. Now moving the camera up, we can see there are some slicks that walk around the background. So I moved the camera a bit up just to see what he exactly does. Well, it seems like he's just moving left to right, so nothing interesting to see here. Taking the camera down, we can get a better look of those spherical buildings here. We can see most of it. Well, when you just play in general, you only see half of it, but not all of it. Well, that was quickly this door. Let's explore this door here. Now in this part, I notice a little fun detail. You see the number 3 on the bird portal. The number actually follows A. When I just let A fly around, I notice that the number is keep looking at him. Okay, a little bit weird, but also a little bit funny at the same time. Like, why would they do that? When I move the camera up, I could get a better look at the place itself, and it looks really cool and much more detailed than Zulak 1. Interestingly enough, when I move to the right here, the buildings here actually continues more and more and more till I reach the end. This is a bit insane. You wouldn't even be able to see all of this, especially that wall. Like, why did they extend it that much? That was this door. Let's explore the last door before entering Zulak 3. Well, sadly, in this store, I couldn't do so much because the camera didn't allow me to do much, like moving left to right or up and down. Well, until I moved the camera straight up, but still, there wasn't really anything interesting I discovered. So let's already continue. Well, now we are gonna move to Zulek 3. In this part here, when I move the camera up, I realized that there isn't that much of a detail in the background, which kinda surprised me because so far I think Rapiophone was the most detailed level of them all. And just seeing this one is, you know what should I say, disappointing? I don't know. But enough of that, let's explore this door. In this door here, we see that all these cages here hanging in there. And moving the camera up, we can see that they're already in right here. We've experienced this before, so I don't think I should talk a lot about that. That was this door, let's explore this door. And in this one, I again couldn't be able to do much with the camera. It was just locked until I moved the camera straight up. The only thing I could do was just zoom the camera in the background. And again, there wasn't that many details to see, so there's nothing really interesting to see here. That was this door. Let's explore the last door before entering the last Zulek room. And in this one, I really wish I could be able to let the camera zoom in, because as you can see, the background is really detailed. We can see a lot of platform, and I tried my best to see if I could be able to let the camera zoom in, but it seems like it doesn't really allow me at all. The only thing I tried was just zooming the camera up just to see the platforms in the background, but didn't got the best experience. So, and again, in the next door before this one, there was nothing really interesting, so let's already continue. And now we are already going into Zulek 4. And here things are getting a bit interesting. At first I moved the camera out to see how it all looks like, and I gotta say, it looks super cool. Especially the lighting and the detail. It reminds me a bit of Exodus, to be honest. But what I really discovered something interesting was in the secret area here. In this area, you can't really go down to the Mordalkans by yourself. But thanks to the fly hack, I could be able. But strangely enough, when I tried to go to the left, I couldn't. It seemed like it was an invisible wall that didn't allow Abe to go there. But when I let Abe go there on the other side with the fly hack, for some reason I couldn't be able to let Abe move at all. That was a bit weird. It seems like there is a lot of problems here if Abe reaches this area. Now before reaching the final part of the game, there is this part here where you get the red ring to destroy all the leaks, the bombs, and the slugs. Now, going to the left into this part where you save those three Mordalkan and get the shrinkle power. Okay, I'm sorry, I know I said the red ring because I was thinking about the Odyssey one. Sorry, man, it's been a long time I played Demon Tasty. It changes things a bit. Forgive me with that. Now in this part, I want to see what was on the other side of this part here. And when I did that, I discovered something interesting in the background. If you move the camera up and to the left, we can see a tunnel that we wouldn't even be able to see. And yeah, on the other side of the cliff, there's nothing. And now, we are now here in the final part of the game. And this is here where things is starting to get interesting. At first, there wasn't really anything else to see in the background or outside of it, so, but it's not that I want to talk about. Now, before I, or when I went to the boardroom and before I pressed the lever, I did a few experiments. At first, I moved Abe down without pressing the lever, let me fall down for myself. And when I moved the camera up again, I realized that all the platforms are gone. This probably happens when you go down and literally everything here disappears. Probably like a trick to save some storage. I'm not sure what else they have planned. When I went back to the boardroom and moved up again, the lighting now turns blue instead. Okay, a little bit funny. The next experiment I did, I pressed the lever, and when the two slicks showed up, I flied a little bit up, and it didn't really trigger the cutscene, and the slicks now froze completely. And then I killed them, and I literally soft-locked myself. Another thing you probably have noticed that the Glockens are not there in the background. That's because they are actually right here. If you move the camera down, you can see them right here with their animation playing right now. The thing is that when you press the lever and an ape falls down, it triggers the animation where the platform has to move up. And since I didn't do that, they just stayed down here. Okay. Now when I went up and pressed the lever, for some reason they teleported up and now the platforms moved down, which is kind of weird because they were down here. It was a bit weird, but okay. Also, now we can now clearly hear what they are saying, because it can be a bit hard for you to hear what they are saying because all of the sleek, the bombs, the explosion, and the alarm itself. So I want to give you a few seconds so you can hear what they are saying. And after that, I had no more experience. Then I pressed the lever normally. And that's all for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching this. And this is also the end of the Out of Bound episode of Exploring New and Tasty. It was an amazing ride. We have now gone through the entire game and seeing how it all looked outside of the camera. What a journey it was. I hope you really enjoyed this mini series. I did so just looking around the camera or outside of the level with this camera. I also want to say again, thanks to Captain 13 and White Snoo for this trainer code. Without that code, I wouldn't ever be able to make this mini series. So again, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you all next time. Bye bye.